Hey guys, this is Audrey Lolita Terry coming up in out of Austin, Texas with the prophetic word for somebody today. The Lord is getting ready to speak to somebody, and the word is, the Lord has answered your prayer. Be obedient to what the Lord is telling you. But before we get into this word today, guys, I just want to have a word of prayer. Pray with me. Father God, we come into prayer, Lord God, just giving you thanks because of who you are, Lord God. Father, I pray that if there's anything in me, Father, that will hinder me from getting a prayer through to your people, Father, Lord, I pray that you remove it right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, if there's any covenant that I have made with the enemy, knowingly or unknowingly, I break that covenant, Father, because my covenant is with you, Jesus. Lord God, if there's any demonic portals that I have opened up, I close them shut and seal them shut with the blood of Jesus in the mighty name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, speak to your people. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Guys, it's just so much, that's going on. And, Lord, when I tell you the Lord has really been dealing with me and speaking to me in so many different ways, you know. And when I say the Lord has answered your prayer, and I want to talk to you guys too as well. Okay, but this prophetic word, I know it's for somebody. It's going to resonate in somebody's spirit. Okay, because it did when the Lord gave it to me. It resonated in my spirit. I knew the Lord was speaking deep down in my spirit. This word is not for everybody, but I know that it's for somebody. Praise God. Give God the glory. And what I want to share with you guys, you know, I had been praying because my lease bought up, right? So I want to go back home. And home for me, what I consider home, guys, is Georgia. So, you know, my daughter is there and I want to go back home. You know, and I was thinking to myself, I was like, Lord, the lease is bought up and, you know, I'm ready to go. So I was making all these plans. You know, I started getting boxes and, you know, just making all these plans. So I began to pray and just seek God on it, because I know anytime that the Lord is in something, he's going to make a way for you to do what you need to do. Okay. When it's for him, when God is in it, he's going to always open the doors for you to walk through. Thank you, Father. So as I began to pray and seek God, look like the harder I pray, guys, the more I felt he didn't want me to leave. And I was like, God, I need more confirmation because I want to go back home. You know, it's nothing here for me in Austin. I could do this ministry anywhere I go. That's just what I told God. And I remember, you know, guys, I was fasting and I remember I went to sleep. I went to sleep and deep sleep. I mean, deep sleep. 3 a.m. My eyes just opened. And when it opened, my phone, I like to go to sleep with, you know, with prophetic words playing. And it's one particular minister that I just love to listen to, and it'd be like on replay. I think he got his own little his little place with me where I got all his messages saved. But this particular message that was playing, he was talking about Lot wife, don't look back. He said, when the Lord bring you from something and somewhere, do not look back. And my eyes, it's like from that deep sleep, like I woke up and I just heard that. And I just laid there in the bed just in shock, you know, kind of sad, because I know that the Lord was speaking to me. He haven't released me to leave Austin, Texas just yet. And y'all, that did something to me. And what I want to share with you guys, a lot of times, and this is not for everybody, please take this word to God in prayer. But a lot of times the Lord have answered us already. And because it's not what we want to hear, we ignore it. We ignore it. The Lord always answers. He said, before you ask, I have answered you. He's saying, while you are speaking, I'm listening. So the Lord, before you even get started, the Lord have already answered your prayers. But a lot of times it's not what we want to hear. It wasn't what I want to hear, you know, because in this place that he had me in, you know, the only people that I know is the people I used to work with, you know, back at my job. And I met a lot of people working there. But then that, you know, it's like God even had me separated from that. And I only see them, you know, if I go back to the place to visit or whatever. But other than that, it's like I have to be very careful and considerate about the company I keep. Not that they're bad people, but sometimes God have you in that place separated where he could use you. It's not a lot of people talking in your ear, okay? It's not a lot of people talking in your ear and speaking in your ear where it's a distraction where you cannot hear from the Lord. It's so important that we be in a place, guys, to be able to hear from the Lord. And it's the place that he put you in. Sometimes it could be lonely. It could be very lonely. You know, it could be very lonely. So we have to just be mindful and careful and always consider what the Lord is speaking into our spirit. The Lord is speaking to somebody today. When Lot's wife, she desired to go back because that's where her heart is. Her heart was back in that place. Okay, she desired to go back. And they had already told that angel had already told them, the Lord had already instructed them not to look back. Okay, because he was getting ready to destroy that city. And they was going forward. Don't look back. Okay, go forward. The Lord is speaking to somebody and don't look back. But she, because she desired to go back, and that's where her heart was, she turned back and turned to a pillar of salt. Do not step out of the will of God. The Lord is speaking to somebody. Okay, I see God before with everything I do, before I even responded to messages. You know, I seek God. That's how much I trust the Lord with everything. Okay? It wasn't, that message wasn't what I wanted to hear. I mean, when God answered my prayer, that wasn't the answer I wanted. I was ready to go back, guys. I was ready to go back. But not saying that I will never get a chance to move back, but the Lord haven't released me as of right now. And I know this. And I've been sitting on this message. I've been sitting on it. But the Lord put in my spirit, do not look back. And this was actually two different nights. Okay, I woke up with the same message playing. Okay, just woke up from out of deep sleep, wide awake. It's like the Holy Spirit wanted to make sure I get that message. The Lord is speaking to somebody. Okay, take this to God in prayer and ask the Lord, is he speaking to you? Okay, a lot of you guys have been praying for certain things about certain situations. And the Lord have given you your answer. And because it's not what you want to hear, okay, we just ignore it. And we continue to pray. And the Lord is saying, I already answered you. I already answered your prayer. I already answered you. So I just, and another thing I wanted to talk about with the chosen ones, when you are chosen, and it's like God have set you aside and pull you away from everything, even your family members. You know, you love your family. I love my family. But even with that, because of the certain lifestyle they live, I don't live. My brother is getting ready to get married, okay, next month. And, you know, he told me, he said, I want you to know that we drank and, you know, and I know you don't do that stuff, but I want you to be at the wedding. I can't go to the wedding. I love my brother. And of course, I want to be there for him, but I can't attend that wedding, okay? Because I got to be obedient to the voice of God. The Bible says, obedient is better than sacrifice. I got to admit, guys, you know, it's not an easy walk when you're walking with the Lord. It's not an easy walk, but it's worth it. I know that it's worth it. And I see in the comment sections and even in the email, some of you guys ask me, you know, am I doing the right thing? I don't understand. I haven't heard anything. Some of you all still are waiting on an answer, and God is going to answer you. You know, he's going to answer. But just keep praying and don't give up. Okay? Keep praying and don't give up. And the way and the way that you know that you are in the right place, I'm going to tell you how you know, because if you wasn't in the right place, you wouldn't be looking at me right now. You wouldn't be watching none of these prophetic videos. You would not be trying to seek the Lord. Okay, you're seeking. Your spirit is thirsting for the Lord. Okay, you desire more. You desire answer. You could be. It's plenty of other places you could go to and be seeking. Okay, especially here on YouTube. But you seek in the Word of God, and you are in the right place. You may not be perfect. None of us are perfect. The Bible says a righteous man fall down seven times and get back up. Seven times, seven times, seven, and you get back up, okay? Because we're all striving. I'm striving every day. This is a walk for me, okay? Even though I may not be out there in the streets and laying up and drinking and doing drugs, but it's still, the enemy still come for me. Because Paul said, every time I desire to do good, evil is always present, okay? So if you're seeking the Lord and you're serving the Lord, okay, evil is going to always be present. There's no way out of that when you seeking the Lord. Just be prayerful and stay up under the covering of God, knowing that the enemy cannot attack you unless you come from up under the blood of Jesus. And everything that happened to you, you know that God has given them permission, okay? A lot of times, not all the time, sometimes we step out on our own. But a lot of times when you're trying to live right and you're seeking a God with your whole heart and the enemy is able to get to you, it's because the Lord has given the enemy permission. He can only go so far. Okay, just always know that. That's why I don't fear when things go on. I go back to the Lord. You know when attacks and certain things come, and I was like, I go back to the Lord and I say, Lord, is there anything I'm doing wrong? Show me myself, you know. Reveal to me if it's anything, Father, that I'm doing that's displeasing unto your sight. Sometimes it's just a test that I have to go through. The Bible says, to whom much is given, much is required. Okay, a lot of us want the blessing. Okay, and we want it for God to expand our territory, but we don't want to go through the test. That test is something else. But the Lord is requiring more from us. He want more from us. Okay, he want more. I pray, guys, that this word bless somebody. Okay, I pray that this Lord bless somebody. And I want you guys to know that I am reading the emails and the comments, and I'm getting a lot of young people emailing me. I want you to know I read the emails and I am praying for you guys. And the Lord just has so many great things in store for you. You're on the right track. Keep seeking the Lord. Keep chasing the Lord. As I say, keep stalking him. Okay, run him down. Even when he quiet, I still pray because I know he hear me. And it get hard sometimes because sometimes the Lord do get quiet. Okay, but when he speak. And he speaks silently, but with so much authority. And he speak to us in different ways, sometimes in different, it down in your spirit without saying anything. Sometimes it could be a sign. Okay, it's just so many different ways the Lord speak. And I just pray today that the Lord continue to make us sensitive to his voice, because he's saying in his word, my sheep will know my voice, and a stranger's voice that will not follow. Praise God. And I just want to say, guys, I'm just blown away right now. It took everything to just keep from crying. You know, walking in his calling, it's been hard, but the Lord has been so good. Oh my God, you guys have really been blessing his ministry. I just want to say thank you. You know, a special thank you to all the donations. And I just pray that God would just overflow you with blessings. It really does something to me, because the things that God is doing in my life, I never expected. Okay. I never even prayed to be rich and for money. My prayer is just always, Lord, just don't leave me, Father, whatever you do. Because see, money will fade away, but the word of God will never fail you, and it'll never fade. When everything else fade, when your money run out, family turn their back on you, friends walk away from you, loved ones, God said, I'll never leave you, nor would I forsake you, and nor will your seed beg your bread. And I believe that. And I feel like long as I have God, that is enough. It's more than enough. So it's never been my prayer, Lord, make me rich. You know, fill up my bank account. I just want more of God, more wisdom, more knowledge, more of the spirit of discernment. Because when I got that, I could make wise decisions, even with my money. Okay? But I pray that this message bless you guys. And I want to offer an invitation for those of you that don't know the Lord and haven't received the Lord as your personal Savior. Today is the day. You don't know him. Today is the day to receive him as your personal Savior. If you believe Christ died on the cross for your sins and rose from the dead, you are saved. Okay, repeat this after me, and I'm going to sit this in a description box in case I go too fast. Dear Lord Jesus, I know that I am a sinner, and I ask for your forgiveness. I believe you died on the cross for my sins and rose from the dead. I turn from my sins and invite you to come into my life as my Lord and Savior. If you said this with me, the sinner's prayer, and you believe this, you are saved. The next step would be baptism and to get up under in a ministry somewhere where you could get the word of God. Okay, just know that I love you, but the Lord love you even more. And he haven't forgotten about you. I know times are hard, but the word of God say, be not weary. And I know it's hard. I know it's hard. I want y'all to hear me. I know it's hard. I know you having a hard time. Okay. But it's important that we don't get distracted and focus too much on our situation, that we keep our eyes on God, because the enemy is throwing all these distractions to try to take our focus off God. Okay. So we'll get off tour and our spirit will get weakened, because without prayer, that's what's going to happen. Okay. It's going to mess with our prayer life. So we know the situation is there, but we going taking it straight to the source. Okay. Because people can't work it out, but the Lord can. So we got to be prayerful and just keep our eyes, no matter what come my way, keep your eyes on the prize. And that prize is Jesus. Keep your focus and praying and aiming, because the enemy, I notice a lot of the chosen ones are under attack. The enemy is attacking family members, anybody he can, to try to pull us off track and take our focus off of God. But we got to be steadfast, like Paul say, unmovable. Okay. Undefeated, because our Father is undefeated. And just pray, even when we don't hear anything and God is not saying anything, pray anyway. Pray and push. We got to push and press our way through this. It's not easy, but do it. Pray and push. You can't afford to give up. We can't give up. Okay, we've come too far to look back. Okay, the Lord say, don't look back. Keep going forward. Keep pressing towards tomorrow. God bless. And I love you guys, but like I said before, the Lord love you more. Bye. Until next time, guys.